Hello everyone and welcome, Dom here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create duck delays in Cubase in two ways. The traditional way, but also another way that's very, very cool. So I'm going to start with the traditional classic way to create a duck delay in Cubase. And I'm going to also explain what a duck delay is along the way. So if you don't know what a duck delay is, fear not, I'm going to show you exactly what it is and what it does and why you need it for your productions. So let's have a listen to my track here.
Let the rain pour down on me.
And our first step to create this classic duct delay is to add a delay, of course. So the right way to do this is to create a delay send effect. And if you want to do this, you click on the E symbol here, you open your channel settings, and then all we need to do is go to our sends here, right click, and select add effects channel to send one, or any slot, it doesn't have to be send one. So we do this, and I'm going to add the ping pong delay from Cubase, and I'm going to call this effect voxed duck delay, add track, and there we go. Now I've added a delay to this vocal. So the first thing I want to do when I add a delay like this is turn the mix all the way up to 100%. I want it to be fully wet. I don't want the dry signal here because we just added this delay as a send effects, as an effect channel. So let's say I want to have a delay of 8th notes, I want to make it really wide. Let's send some of the vocal to the delay, and let's have a listen.
Let the rain pour down on me.
Yeah, so this vocal now has some delay, but at what cost? Now, the vocal is confused, it's drowned in this delay, and we can't really hear the words, it's kind of blurry as well, and that's the typical problem that you're going to encounter when you add delay to the vocal. And then the only way to tame this is to either automate the delay send, like this, or make it quiet.
Let the rain pour down on me.
But we still don't have a lot of control over those delays. So what a duck delay would do in this case, it would basically, when we have the vocal present, like in this section, the delays would go down in volume, they would be ducked, they would be compressed. But when we reach this point, where we have silence in the vocal, and the vocal is not present, then the delays will gradually come up to fill this space. And this is great because we're filling this space with these beautiful delays. So let me show you how you set this up in Cubase. It's actually super, super simple. The only thing we need to do is go to our duct delay channel. Here is the ping pong delay. And on the second insert slot, or it doesn't matter, it has to be after the delay, we go ahead and add a compressor. So the Cubase compressor will do just fine. It's perfect for the job. And now the only thing we need to do is set up a simple sidechain. This is actually exactly the same way you set up a sidechain for anything else, for a kick drum and a bass, for example. So all you need to do is activate the sidechain, and then we can go to our cogwheel here and select what channel is going to trigger this compressor as a sidechain input. And I'm going to go here, and in case you haven't guessed it already, we're going to use the vocal to trigger the compressor so that when the vocal is present, the compressor will be triggered and the level of the delay will go down. Now, the things that we need to make sure here is that our level is at 0 dB, and the next thing we want to make sure is that our sidechain is set to prefader. Now, why is this important? It's important because when we want to change the level of the vocal here, okay, like this, then we want to make sure that this level of the fader won't affect our sidechain and it won't trigger the compressor in a different way. We want to trigger the compressor with a steady signal. We don't want this to be affected by our level here. So that's why we need to make sure that this is prefader. Now, the only thing we need to do is adjust our threshold and we'll be good to go. Let's try it. So let's have a listen.
Let the rain pour down on me. So now we're dancing in the rain.
So as you can hear, where we have the vocal present, the compressor gets triggered and the delay level goes down. And where we have the vocal not present, the delays come up. And depending on how low I set the threshold, I'm going to get more of a duct delay sound. And the other very cool thing is that I can have total control over how fast the delays will come back in by using the release. So if I set a slow release, you will see that the delays will take a little bit more time to come up. Let's have a listen.
Let the rain pour down on me.
But if I make it very fast, it's going to be way, way faster. See? So most of the times for a natural duct delay sound, I would go for something around 300 milliseconds at least. Okay, or even longer sometimes, but it depends on the track, it depends on the kind of effect you want to achieve, so this is not set in stone. And if I want a less pronounced duct delay sound, I can just pull up the threshold.
Let the rain pour down on me.
But if I deactivate the compressor altogether,
let the rain pour down.
Massive difference. Now, this, of course, works universally. It works for delays, it works for reverbs, it doesn't really matter. You can also use it if you want to have a delay followed by a reverb, for example. Let's do this, shall we? I'm going to add a reverb after the ping pong delay. I'm going to add a revelation instance, and I'm going to set it to, let's say, like 60% and long reverb as well. Let's have a listen.
Let the rain pour down on me. So now we're dancing in the rain.
So you can create some really interesting and creative effects using ducking in Cubase. And as you can see, it's super, super easy to set up. But now I'm going to show you a second way that you can create ducking delays. And in my opinion, this gives you even more control. Let me show you the next way, which is by using the amazing multi-tap delay that we have in Cubase. And let me show you how this works. First of all, I'm going to go to my vocal here. I'm going to deactivate these. And I'm going to assign one of the slots to the multi-tap delay, which I have already created. Exactly in the same way like I showed you before. So first, let's listen to this without the ducking.
Let the rain pour down on me.
Again, very interesting delay sound, but the vocal is blurry, it's confused, it gets messed up really quickly. Now let me show you how easily you can add ducking with multi-tap delay. All you need to do is go right here to the ducker and just turn up the amount. And here we also have a release control. It works exactly the same way like I showed you before with the compressor. So let's try this and check out the difference.
Let the rain pour down on me. So now we're dancing in the rain.
So it cleans up really nicely, it's more focused, but we still get those beautiful tails in the end. Now, the great thing with multi-tap delay is that it has two aces up its sleeve, and it's these two buttons. And these are the secret sauce for amazing duct delays. Let me show you what they do, because they are really, really important and they do some incredible things. First of all, let's listen to this vocal with the duct delay and pay attention to the tails, okay? I'm going to turn both of these off.
Let the rain pour down on me.
So what can we hear? Let the rain go down on me, and you know, the extension of this last syllable. And it's all very chaotic. There's a lot of things going on there. And this is what you would normally get with a delay that has a high feedback value, okay? You hear all the words and they get messed up in the end. Now, let me show you what happens if I use this control here. This basically, what it does is it suppresses the feedback when ducking takes place. So when the vocal is present, the feedback is going to be suppressed. And I don't want to go too technical about it, but listen to the result when I turn it on.
Let the rain pour down on me.
See, we only get the delay of the last bit of the phrase. It's nice, it's clean, it's basically a delay throw without you having to do any automation, any complicated stuff. MultiTab Delay does this for you. It's incredible and it's very, very powerful, and this will always give you a cleaner delay sound, a cleaner duck delay. Now, I want to show you this control here because this is also very powerful, okay? Now, I'm going to turn the feedback really, really high, and check what happens when we go from this phrase to this phrase, and check what happens here, okay?
Let the rain pour down on me. So now we're dancing in the rain.
Okay, so it's really, really chaotic, and sometimes you might want this, but in the context of a track, if you want a clean sounding track with a clean duck delay, this will really mess it up for you. But check what happens when I use this control here. This will basically erase the delay line between the phrases. So as you can see, we have a little bit of silence here. So what will happen is that the delay lines will be erased from here to here. I'm gonna play it for you and you're going to see the difference.
Let the rain pour down on me. So now we're dancing in the rain.
Hear that? So basically, over here we have a delay line for this section, and over here we get rid of this delay line and we only have the delays for this phrase, which is really, really powerful. And if we combine both of them, you will see that even though I have such a high feedback here, see, super high feedback, check how much cleaner and more focused the delays are when I have both of these on.
Let the rain pour down on me. So now we're dancing in the rain.
So I challenge you to try any delay that you want, set the feedback to 80-90% and do the same thing. It's going to be a big, big mess. What MultiTab Delay does here is really, really unique. If you want to emulate this behavior with another delay, you have to do a lot of automation, a lot of crazy, tricky stuff in order to clean up your delay, because such high feedback values will create a big delay mess. MultiTab Delay makes it so easy to create these long delays, duck delays that sound like delay throws that you automated. It's extremely powerful and it's one of the most important tricks to have up your sleeve for delays, if you ask me. So there you go, this is how you can create duck delays in Cubase, the classic way, but also with a twist. I hope you enjoyed this video, I hope you have loads of fun, and I'll see you on the next one, bye bye.